Hello, thanks for joining me today. I'm Jackie and I create sea glass mosaics. And today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the work that I do with sea glass. So I've been creating sea glass mosaics for about 10 years. And I've decided to start doing a little bit of videoing about that. And this is my first ever YouTube video, so you'll have to be patient with me. Here goes. What I'm planning to do is to talk to you about the different sea glass mosaics that I've made and the process that I've used. And I'm going to show you what I've done to create some beautiful works of art from the pieces of sea glass that I've found at the beach over the years. I grew up in Prince Edward Island in Canada, eastern shore of Canada, and I have been collecting sea glass for as long as I can remember, so my entire life. And I live in Nova Scotia, but I have a cottage in PEI, and so I only get to the island in the summer, but I collect as much sea glass as I can when I'm there, and I have a pretty extensive collection. So about 10 years ago, my husband and I were building our own cottage in PEI and my dad was helping me, and I wanted to put a window between the living room and the bedroom, and I said to my dad, I'd like to put a stained glass window in there. And he said, well, why would you make it in stained glass? Why don't you cover it in sea glass? And once I got that window done, I was hooked. I've made a ton of sea glass projects since then. And I want to show you a bunch of those today, and then as my videos go on, I'm going to get into some more detail about how I created them and show you how you can make your own, because I find there's not a lot of people doing this type of art. At the time when I tried to figure this out, I couldn't find any information about it, so I'm hoping to provide you with information so you can make some sea glass mosaics yourself. I'll give you lots of tips on what has worked for me and what hasn't worked for me, so that maybe you can avoid some of the pitfalls that I've made in a number of things that I've been doing, and hopefully you'll all come away creating some beautiful pieces of art. So I think I will show you some of my work. So I call this one Earth, Water, Sky, and it was one of the first pieces I ever did and still is one of my favorites, even though I've done many pieces since this. I call this one Once in a Blue Moon, and it really features a beautiful blue round piece that I put in the sky to act as a moon. And I call this one Little Lighthouse because obviously it's a lighthouse and it's little. And I really quite like lighthouses, and I've done quite a few of them in my sea glass mosaics. And I call this one Jump for Joy. It's a silhouette of a person on the beach jumping for joy. I like to do silhouettes quite a bit as well, so you'll see that as a bit of a recurring theme. And I call this one Eagle in a Tree because it's an eagle in a tree, another example of a silhouette. And I call this one Blomidon View, and that's an example of a landscape, and I quite like using the sea glass to create landscapes. So, and this is a view from my house, which I quite like. And this is the same view again, similar, very similar, just a little bit of a smaller version of the Blomidon View. And I call this one Flowing Lines in a Frame. And flowing lines I really like, so I've done quite a few pieces that have those flowing lines in them. And I'll do another video about that and tell you a bit more about the whole flowing lines design that I use quite a bit. I call this one Creating Waves in France, another example of flowing lines. And I call this one Creating Waves in PEI, and it features a beautiful stone for a focal point from our beach in PEI. And I call this one California Sand Dollar because the focal point is a beautiful sand dollar that was found on a beach in California. And I call this one Three Flowers because there are three flowers, one in each pane of glass. I call this one Fall Grass because it's actually a life-size depiction of a blade of grass, grass that grows in our backyard in the fall. And I call this one Lighthouse on the Rocks because it's a lighthouse overlooking the water, sitting on a bunch of rocks. I call this one Fanciful Flowers, and because it's using sea glass and rocks and shells to show flowers, but they're not really any an identifiable species. They're actually fanciful. And I call this one Tree of Life. It's a sea glass mosaic on a frame from a church, old church window, antique vintage church window. And I call this one Sailboat Regatta. There's one main sailboat and then a bunch of small sailboats in the background. I call this one Blue Heron, or Great Blue Heron, and it's a silhouette of a heron sitting on the beach. And I call this one Trinity, and it represents God, Jesus, and Holy Spirit. And I call this one Our Beach. It's a picture of our beach in PEI. Helps remind me about being at the beach when I can't be there. And I call this one Under the Water. And this is my most recent piece. So I showed you one of my earliest pieces, and this is my most recent one that I just finished. I just wanted to point out here in the right-hand corner, there's an inukshuk, and I put one of those in every one of my pieces, and it's a sign that I was here. And I think the fact that we all leave things behind us when we've been there, just a reminder that we need to be aware of what we leave behind. And if you want to look close in all of my pieces, you'll find at least one inukshuk in each one. Thanks for joining me today and hearing a little bit about my sea glass art. I hope you'll tune in my future videos and see all sorts of interesting things that I've been doing with sea glass and creating art. And I hope that you'll subscribe to my channel and maybe even check out my book. You can find information about that on my website, jackietrimperseaglass.com. Thanks very much.